Welcome to today's handstand flow. We'll be guiding you through some techniques to warm up, stretch and prep for a handstand. So when you're ready, please join me in a tabletop position, bringing the palms underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Just release the feet to the mat. Can you just start to apply some pressure now to the wrist, just starting to warm up the wrist now. Start to slowly rock the body forwards and back, just applying a little bit of pressure through the wrist. And then reverse, flipping the hands, coming onto the back of the palms. Make sure to push the elbows towards the front, taking a breath in. As you exhale, just slowly lower yourself back, really feeling that stretch. Nothing too intense here. Just be mindful of the wrist. We just want to carefully, slowly apply a bit of pressure, warming them up, gently rocking the body forwards and back. And then slowly now release, bringing the fingertips out towards the side of the mat. Apply a little bit of pressure to the right side, to the left side. And again, now just slowly rocking side to side. And again, one more time, now flip the fingertips to face inwards towards each other. Again, just apply a little bit of pressure. Be mindful, this can be quite intense on the wrists. If it becomes too intense, just make sure you apply more pressure in your knees, more weight in the knees, so there's not too much weight on the hands. You want to slowly warm them up. Just flip them over, bring the seat back. Just begin to rotate the wrist clockwise, anti-clockwise. Just find that release, that movement through the wrist. Bring the palms down. Again, come into a tabletop position now. This time, full circle rotation with the entire body moving in a clockwise direction. Big circles, applying that pressure through the wrists. And then reverse in the direction. Okay, come back to center, bringing the palms back underneath the shoulders. Take an inhale, lower the belly, lift the chest, lift the gaze with a cow tilt. On the exhale, really round in the upper back. Really press those palms into the mat, drawing the chin towards the chest. See, this is the motion that we need when we're trying to press into a handstand, this contraction with the upper back. So from here, tuck the toes under, lift the knees away from the mat, keep the back exactly how it is, and then lift the hips all the way up the back, just coming into a downward facing dog now. Find a bit of stretch through the palms all the way to the hips, drawing the navel in. And then keeping the weight into the palms. Draw the navel in, start to lift the hips as you tiptoe yourself towards the top of the mat. Keep lifting the hips high, coming as close as you can before you have to release the hands. palms forward. As you exhale, come into a standing split. So if you need to have a slight bend in that right knee, have a bend. Take a deep breath in, reaching the chest forward. As you exhale, lower the chest, reaching that left foot all the way up to the sky. And again, really trying to find that length as you lift the left foot high. Take a deep breath in, create a bit of space. As you exhale, fold. Now plant the palms down, really press the palms. Start to lift that left foot up as you send that right foot back. Yeah? Keep reaching that left foot to the sky, keep pressing those palms down. If you want to, you can take a little switch kick, kicking the left foot up, the right foot down, landing into a plank pose. Slower down, chaturanga. Straight into an upward facing dog. Hips up and back, downward facing dog. Again, just take a full breath in to recharge. And a full breath out, sigh it out. Release anything that's not serving you right now. Left foot reaches all the way up and back, bending that knee, opening through the hip. And again, try to open the left knee, coming onto the right ball of the foot, lifting that heel, finding more space through the body. Start to draw that left knee in towards the chest. As you round in the upper back, pressing the heels of the hands down. Left foot is stepping forward. Inhale into a high lunge. Create space through the side body. Send the fingertips up high as you inhale. As you exhale, go a little bit deeper with it. From here, weight shifting forward over that left foot, coming into your warrior three. Extend that right heel all the way back. Arms by the side, flex the right toes. Draw the navel in, square off the hips from here. Inhale, reaching the fingertips out in front of you. As you exhale, fold over the legs, stand in splits. Try to reach that right foot all the way up. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, go a little bit deeper. And again, deep full breath in. Keep reaching that right foot up as much as you can. As you exhale, fold over the leg. Then plant the palms down. Send that right foot a little bit higher as you hop that left foot back. And again, come onto the ball of that left foot. Try to reach the right toes high. From here, kick and switch towards the sky. Lower and down, right toes, left toes. Into a chaturanga. Straight into an upward facing dog. Hips lifted up and back. Downward facing dog. Just take a full breath in here. And a full breath out. From here, lower back down onto your knees. Bring the palms underneath the shoulders. You need to just find a little bit of release through the wrists. Just rotate them one at a time. Yeah? Be mindful of your wrists through this practice. There's a lot of pressure onto them. Now from here, make sure you spread out the fingertips and the inside of the elbows to face towards the front, really pressing those palms down. Take an inhale as you lower the belly, lifting the chest, the gaze, and on the exhale, really rounding that upper back. Yes, so press those hands down. Now lift the knees off the mat. Come into a downward facing dog almost, but not fully into it. The left foot steps forward slightly, the right toes come behind you. From here, shift your weight forward, soft bend in that left knee. See if you can kick that right foot up into an L shape almost. And again, a little bit of work requires you to have a bit of effort to kick. From here, step the left foot back, lower down onto the knees. Just bring the seat back towards the heels. Stretch the palms out in front of you, taking a full breath in and a full breath out to recharge. And again, slowly now coming back onto the palms. Again, into a cat-cow as you inhale, just lower the belly, lift the chest, lift the gaze. On the exhale, rounding the upper back, really pressing the heels of the hands down. Now come into a neutral breath. Breathe normally, keep it here with this contraction with the upper back. Tuck the toes under, lift the knees up. Step that right foot slightly forward, point that left toe behind you. We're kicking up again with the left foot first. Slight bend in that right knee. Hop. Jump.
place. And again, stretch the palms out in front of you. Take a full breath in and a full breath out. Just try to find space through the side body. Again, jumping up for handstands can be quite tiring. So make sure that you use your breath to recharge. And full breath out. And again, from here, come back into a downward facing dog, lifting the hips up and back. Reach the right foot up to the sky, bend the knee, open the knee. Draw the right knee towards the chest. Just step it forward, not all the way into in between the palms. We want to kick that left foot back to the sky. So again, soft bend in that right knee, flexing the left toes. Really press those palms down. Use the fingertips as grips. Take an inhale as you exhale, jump into an L shape with the legs. Eventually, you'll be able to hold. You might fall a little bit, and that's fine. We're only human. From there, step both feet back. If you can, lower down, chaturanga, if you have the strength. If not, knees, chest, chin. Press all the way up, upward facing dog. Hips lifting up and back, downward facing dog. Let's try this one more time with the left side. So left foot reaching up and behind you, opening through that hip, coming onto the ball of the right foot. And again, extend that left foot towards the sky. Just step it forward, in between the palms and in between the back foot. And again, soft bend in that left knee. Right toes remain flexed. Keep pressing the palms down, engage through the shoulders. Look in between the hands. Yeah, use your strength and your willpower to get you up. Take an inhale as you exhale. Right foot lifts up. L shape with the legs. You might find that you start to hold it a little bit longer. Yeah? Try it one more time. Coming back down, stepping both feet back, lowering down the knees. Bringing the seat all the way back. Stretch those palms out in front of you. Bow the forehead to the mat. Take a deep, full breath in through the nose. As you exhale, sigh it out. Release it. Release the fatigue. Release the tiredness. You don't need it. One more time. Deep, full breath in. And a full exhale out. From here, slowly now shift the weight forward. Just stretch out through the chest. Bring the palms out in front of you, take a breath in. As you exhale, just try to melt the chest down, bringing the chin towards the mat. Take a full breath in here, and a full breath out. And again, deep full breath in, full breath out. One more time. Deep breath in, create some space. As you exhale, try to melt the chest. Slowly now lifting yourself up, bringing the palms all the way back. Just sit back into the heels, bringing the knees together if that's a comfortable sitting position for you. And again, just make sure that we are rotating those wrists. We really start to feel that pressure that we apply through the practice. Spend a little time with mobility, loosening them up, clockwise, anti-clockwise. Let the palms rest on top of the knees, close down the eyes, relax the face. Take a full deep breath in and sigh it out through the mouth. Deep breath in through the nose. Really filling up the body, filling up the chest. Sigh it out. And again, deep full breath in. And a full breath out. Thank you for practicing. Know that it requires a lot of work. It's not something that you get straight away. Very quick tutorial. Maybe another time we can spend a bit more time working into it, but hopefully here's some little tips and basics that can set you off on your way. And just have fun with it. Thank you. Namaste.